Hallelujah. Satan is always messing, but God is always blessing. Church, say amen. Thou who art God, our Father, we thank you for this moment. As we've come to the preaching hour here at Young Missionary, we ask now that your words, O God, would be a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our pathway. For faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So God, take these little words of preparation, O God, and roll over them with the Holy Spirit, that your people might grow in faith, in holiness, and in righteousness. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. As I began, I just want to begin in this way. I need a little help because this is going to be a little interactive. Amen? Church, say amen. And I'm talking to those that have been around for a little while before they came out with contemporary gospel. Amen. Before they came out with traditional gospel, even. And before they even came out with the hymns, there was something called spiritual. I want to see how many of them you know. I'm going to start it, and I'm going to see if y'all can finish it. If you can finish it, I want you to holler it out. Wade in the water, God. Okay, y'all good. Y'all got that. Swing low, sweet. And what it's coming to do? All right, all right, all right, all right. I'm going to lay all my burdens. All right, all right. Who 3 for 3? Anybody here 3 for 3? Okay, all right. Let me see that. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. That's right. Church, say amen. How about this one? Deep. Not water. Nope. Deep river. That's right. That's right, church. Amen. Amen. Nobody knows. Everybody know that one, though. Mary. No, Mary. No, baby. Said. They got it over here. The older, they got it over here. Say amen. Mary, don't you? And what we don't want Martha to do? All right, all right. Take my hand and do what?
Lead me on.
All right, all right. But my favorite scripture, AJ, I hope I'm ready. All right, amen. But my personal all-time favorite is taken from the book of Exodus, which recounts the story of God's people departing from the house of bondage down in Egypt. This being Black History Month, please indulge we and let me have a 2 minutes of personal privilege as I let you hear one of the greatest spiritual songs, my favorite, ever sung by one of the greatest baritones of our race. Anybody know who it is? Nope. Mahalia Jackson wasn't no baritone. Paul Robeson. Just say amen.
When Israel was in Egypt's land, let my people go. Oppressed so hard they could not stand, let my people go. Go down, Moses, way down in Egypt's land. Tell all Pharaoh to let my people go. spake the Lord bold Moses said, let my people go. If not, I'll smite your firstborn dead. Let my people go. Go down, Moses, way down in Egypt's land. Tell
As a black race, the Bible for us has sometimes been complex. It's been complex because it served a dual purpose. There were times in which the Bible was used to oppress us, and yet the Bible is a great liberating force. Although God is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore, He changes not. Amen. The culture can change the value of the text. An example of the culture changing the value of the text in Leviticus 19 and 28, it says, do not cut your bodies for the dead or put tattoo marks on yourselves. I am the Lord. However, in these days and times, because of the value of the text and the loss, it has lost its value. Many Christians and non-Christians have gotten ink all over their bodies. For many years, women covered their heads in the church. Today, very rarely do you see a woman with a hat on. Time and culture has brought about the devaluation of some scripture. We must consider that the Bible is regarded, has come down through both the oral and the written tradition. The Bible is the inspired word of God written by men by the direction of the Holy Spirit. The Bible is filled with life-affirming words that God can write on the tablets of our hearts. Moses gave Pharaoh four words. Let my people go. These four words have been put to music, as you've just heard, but these four words have been the cry of many seeking deliverance from others. These four words, let my people go, has been the ultimate cry in the prayers of the intercessors down through the ages. These four words did not start in Exodus. Amen. But these, when we look at the origin of these words and the origin of why Moses had to be born and sent to tell Pharaoh these three words, we realize that when God was speaking to Abraham in Genesis 15 and 13, amen, he said, then the Lord said unto Abram, you can be sure that your descendants will be strangers in a foreign land, and that they will be oppressed as slaves for 400 years. The book of Genesis ends with the body of Joseph waiting to be taken out of Egypt. The book of Exodus begins with the birth of Moses. There were 300 years from Joseph's death, amen, to the birth of Moses. Moses was born and he spent 40 years in the palace and being, amen, adopted by Pharaoh's daughter, amen, before he was chased off to spend 40 years in the wilderness where he learned, amen, all the terrain and he learned all of the, how everything was to come to pass as he traveled over the terrain over and over again, not only as a fugitive, but now as a being a part of the tribe of Midian. The Midianites were from Abraham's wife, Keturah. And so Moses got with Jethro, and he married one of Jethro's daughters. Amen. But Moses realized that life is full of ups and downs. Anybody know that? Sometimes you're in the palace, But sometimes God calls you to go into the wilderness. Amen. Sometimes you have it good where you are, and then sometimes you have to go down, amen, and find that one riding in a chariot, amen, like Philip the evangelist, amen, and to tell them about the word of God. In Exodus 3, God calls Moses to go back to Egypt. The word of God tells us that there was a burning bush because the angel had gotten in the bush. There was a burning bush. Amen. And when the bush was burning, Moses turned and he looked at it. And he began to go to where it is. And when he got to where the bush was burning, he realized that the bush was burning, but it was not consumed. And a voice came to Moses and said, Moses, I want you to take your shoes off. Because the ground that you're walking on is holy ground. Church, say amen. Amen. The ground that you're walking on is holy ground. And he said, I need you to do something. And I need you to go and tell Pharaoh to let my people go. Now, Moses looked at God and in the burning bush and said, I'll go, but who am I going to tell him he sent me? God says, say that I am. He said, what's your name? God says, I am that I am. Amen. Moses tell them that the I am send you. Moses said, well, they won't believe me. He said, what's that in your hand? Moses said, a staff. He said, toss it to the ground. And Moses tossed the staff to the ground. Amen. And the staff turned into a snake. Moses jumped back away from it. God said, now grab it by his tail. How many of y'all would grab that snake by his tail? He grabbed the snake by the tail and the stick turned back into a rod. Moses said, I still don't get it. He said, well, tell you what you do. Stick your hand inside and pull it out. And it was full of leprosy. He said, now stick it back in there and pull it out again. And it was clean and crisp as it had been before. Almost like he put some Lubriderm on it when he stuck it in there. Somebody say amen. Amen. And so God said, these are the signs. If they don't believe you, do these signs before the people. And when Moses did these signs before the people, amen, they believed in Moses. But Moses had also told God, I can't go because I'm not eloquent in speech. He said, I want you to take your brother Aaron with you. And Aaron, amen, will speak on your behalf to Pharaoh. Amen. And so it brings us into focus. Our text for today is Exodus 5 and 1. Go with me there. Exodus 5 and 1. Amen. And I'll be sticking to the King's language today. Reading from the King James Version. Amen. And it says, and afterwards, Moses and Aaron went in. They went in to Pharaoh, and thus saith the Lord God of Israel, let my people go, that they may hold a feast unto me in the wilderness. Seven times Moses and Aaron repeated this four-word phrase. And finally, amen, after the 10th plague, amen, Pharaoh decided that he was going to let God's people go. These four words, let my people go, amen, amen, has come down through the ages, through many times, amen. People have cried these four words, let my people go. For being let go, for being set free, being released, amen, is the first step of a journey from bondage, oppression, and even death. If you're being held, you can't go nowhere until somebody let you go. Amen. Y'all know what I'm talking about, right? If you're not going to move forward, you can't go backwards even unless somebody or something let you go. Amen. Now, I don't know what's holding on to you today, whether it's physically, mentally, or spiritually, but I'm here to tell you, you need to stand and say, let my people go. And my text is, there's a Moses in you. Turn to your neighbor and say, there's a Moses in you. Once they let you go, amen, you can be free to move towards life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. God wants his people to be free. He had plans and promises, amen, to fulfill the, them and place them in a land of flowing with milk and honey. The story in Exodus runs parallel, though, to the story of blacks in America. It talks about the enslavement of men and women and Moses, whom God called to deliver and to lead his people to a promised land, a place that God had planned for them, and to a better life. I would like to use the concept of black Moses as a metaphor this morning. I want to use this literary device to make a comparison between the Moses in the text and the black Moses in our history. Let me begin by saying that contrary to modern day music, Isaac Hayes is not the black Moses. Say amen. But a woman named Harriet Tubman, who led hundreds of enslaved persons to freedom, respectfully received the title of the Black Moses. She began her work in the Underground Railroad. I'll give you a black fact right now. Where did the term Underground Railroad come from? In 1831, amen, Trice Davis was a slave from Kentucky. He was wading in the water with his master walking behind him. But after a while, the master looked and he could not find Trice. And so he began to look for him and he was nowhere to be found. Trice became free by swimming across the Ohio River. Somebody say amen. And his master returned to Kentucky in a rage, telling his friends that his slave had gone on the Underground Railroad. And that was the beginning of what would become a legend. The Underground Railroad had no tracks. Amen. No, it had no designated route. Amen. It was a network of free blacks and whites, amen, who helped fugitive slaves find freedom in the northern states and in Canada. Harriet Tubman, just like the biblical Moses, wasn't afraid to go back. She made several trips back down into the South, where she could have been made to be a slave herself again. Amen. But she traveled south to bring many slaves out of slavery into a freedom and to a better life. Say amen. I'm going somewhere with this. In our time, please allow me to expand the metaphor of Black Moses just a little further. Amen. Using the concept of a deliverer, one who goes back and bring others out of oppression to a better life. I contend that Black Moses is still alive today, and there is a Moses in you. In the spirit of Moses and Harriet Tubman, I believe there are persons who realize that it's time to mobilize and energize and inspire our communities. It's time to care for those who are vulnerable. I believe that there are those in the church who are driven by their faith in God and conviction that all individuals are created equal, although we are living in a time when this is far from self-evident. I'm telling you right now, if they could put you back in the field, amen, they would do it tomorrow. If they could pass legislation to put you back out there picking that cotton, amen, because they are trying to, watch this now, they're trying to keep all the Hispanics and the ones that's coming in out. So once they don't come and do it no more, who you think they want to do it? Help me somebody. Amen. Moses was a conductor. Harriet Tubman was a conductor who sang these words, "Go down, Moses, way down in Egypt land, and tell my old Pharaoh to let my people go." Amen. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was a conductor. He was a Moses, leading his people in the quest for civil rights and dreamed of a promised land. He said, "Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that." There is a Moses in you, and there is a Moses in me. A zeal, amen, for people to have a better life, to be free, to dream, to believe, and to inspire others. Mary McLeod Bethune, amen, she says, "For I am my mother's daughter, and the drums of Africa still beat in my heart." We've got to make a stand. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, Moses made a stand. He went and stood before Pharaoh and said, let my people go. We've got to be willing to make a stand. Society may be using different names, but it's still Pharaoh. Pharaoh, watch this now. But Pharaoh should know not to mess with God's people. Amen. For no weapon formed against us shall prosper. It is our heritage. In Exodus 1 and 16. Amen. When you, it says, when you are helping the Hebrew women and children. Watch this now. In Exodus 1 and 16. Amen. It was talking to those. Pharaoh was talking and his cronies was talking to the Hebrew ones that nursed the children. Amen. And birthed the children. He told them, said, when you are giving birth to the Hebrew women. Watch this. When they in childbirth and on the delivery stool, if you see it's a boy baby, kill him. Amen. But if it's a girl, let her live. Amen. In chapter 24, you know, you reap what you sow. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, you reap what you sow. In chapter 4, amen, verse 22, then said Moses to Pharaoh, this is what the Lord says. Israel is my firstborn son. And I told you, let my son go so he can worship me. But you refuse to let him go. So I will kill your firstborn. Just like you killed all the firstborn when Moses was born, I'm going to kill your firstborn for messing with my firstborn Israel. Amen. Now, God made Pharaoh experience his pain and his loss. Amen. For his own firstborn Israel. And we have to make a stand against the pharaohs of our day. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, Pharaoh's alive and well. Is this stick making y'all scared? No? I can put it down there? Nah, I'm going to hold on to it. Say amen. Amen. Church say amen. Amen. Pharaoh, tell your neighbor, Pharaoh is alive and well today. Amen. And we have to stand against the pharaohs of our day. Yes. What's some of the pharaohs that's alive right now? Inequality. How many of y'all know you still make a lot less than your counterparts, your European counterparts? Say amen. Pay equality is not the same. Amen. Amen. Injustice. How many of y'all know injustice still is in the land? Say amen. Come on, help me. Go with me. We've got to realize our destiny. We got to bring all the gifts that our ancestors gave, says Maya Angelou. Amen. I am the dream and the hope of a slave. I rise, I rise, I rise. Oprah Winfrey said, I am where I am because of the bridges that I crossed. Amen. How many of y'all know you crossed some bridges? But there was somebody that helped, that was a bridge for you. I thank God for everybody in my life that helped me get to where I am today. They were my bridges. Help me, somebody. And so Oprah Winfrey said, I am where I am today because of the bridges that I have crossed. Sojourner Truth was a bridge. Harriet Tubman was a bridge. Ida B. Wells was a bridge. Madam C.J. Walker was a bridge. Fannie Lou Hamer was a bridge. Barack Hussein Obama, amen, was a black Moses. He was a bridge. He was a conductor. Say amen. And he led us out of the worst financial crisis since the Great Depression. As change leaders, their job, amen, was to shepherd their people through the desert, through the grueling process of change. Jesus himself is a Moses. He was a typology of Moses, and Moses was a typology of Jesus. Look at it now. Both were hidden, amen, at the birth from death from an evil ruler. Both went into Egypt to escape death as children. Amen. Both were adopted. Both saved women at the well. Both became shepherds. Both performed signs and miracles. Moses offered his life to save his people who sinned when they created a golden calf. Jesus gave his life to save his people from his sins. Amen. The spirit of Moses is the spirit of Jesus. And all who don't mind taking just one person and leading them out of bondage and leading them into a better life. I wish I had some Moseses here today that don't mind taking a child and making that child's life a little better. We got some Moseses in our midst. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, there's a Moses in you. Amen. Jesus is the director of our soul. He is the conductor of our life. Where he leads me, I will follow. Where he needs me, I will go. Moses, now watch this. Now, Moses had to get, amen, the people out of Egypt. But he also had to get Egypt. Help me, somebody. Who said, Brother Johnny? But he also had to get Egypt out of the people. How many of y'all know folk that you're trying to get them to a higher plane? And they just want to stay where they are? Some folk are comfortable in their sin. Some folk are comfortable with the life they lead. To change, to try to get them to change is to put them in a zone that they are not comfortable with. I'm comfortable not having money. Give me some money, I act a complete fool. Help me somebody, say amen. Turn your neighbor, say neighbor. Lead them out of Egypt. But get Egypt out of them. Amen. Sometimes people don't want to move. There are those who wanted to go back to Egypt when soon as things got rough, they said, we want to go back to Egypt. And then there were others that said, no, let's just stone Moses and be done with it. Amen. Amen. They wanted to stone him. And it took Moses 40 years, amen, to get Egypt out of them. How many of y'all been praying for folk for almost 20, 30, 10, 15, 20 years? They ain't seem to be changing not one bit. They just stand where they are. They ain't even trying. You talking to them. You doing everything for them. Amen. And they ain't trying to get no better. They ain't trying to get to no higher plane. They're not trying to help and serve in this community in which we call faith. Amen. The old generation had to die off before the promised land was reached. And we say now, how long will America wander in the wilderness of fear, arrogance, ignorance, intolerance, selfishness? How long will Moses attempt to lead the charge for change and hope? I'm almost finished. Pharaoh has our people, and we need to tell Pharaoh, let my people go. And if Moses had showed up, amen, in front of me with a stick this big, I would have let him go the first time. Somebody say amen. Amen. But it took 10 plagues, amen, for him to finally get to the point, amen, that he let God's people go, because God was controlling his heart. God softened his heart. God hardened his heart. And it's a call that let my people go is a call that challenges Christians to see people set free, both physically, mentally, socially, emotionally, spiritual. We got to tell God, tell Pharaohs, the Pharaohs that's holding them, to let my people go. And it's a reason that God wants you to let them go. He wants you to get them free. He wants you to lead them to a higher place. He wants you to take them to the promised land, because God wants you to, in the midst of the wilderness, he wants his people to stop and to worship him. The word of God tells us that when Moses had them out there, they finally free, parted the Red Sea, amen, by holding up his staff against the waters, amen. And when they got to the other side, after Moses had gone 3 days, Moses stopped and made a feast unto God. Amen. This is why God wants people to be free. So that they can serve him, so that they can worship him. Let my people go is a cry that has came down throughout the ages. The Jews during the time of Holocaust cried out to let my people go. Amen. Nelson Mandela in the African National Congress, ANC, amen, was crying, let my people go. Amen. Dr. Martin Luther King and all those black and white who stood against injustice and racism, inequality and Jim Crow cried out, let our people go. Amen. Told pharaohs of the world, let my people go. Where is the spirit of Moses today? Does the spirit of Moses dwell in you? Who are you helping to get to a better place? Who are you helping to get to a better life? Is it all about you? Are you selfish? But you got to tell somebody, I'm going to a higher plane. I'm going to a higher life. Help me somebody. There are mothers whose sons are caught up in the prison industrial complex, which have moved the complex that was established to move people from the plantation to the prison. Mass incarceration is still a lucrative business and a vibrant, amen, part of America. Now, how are you still going to have folk locked up for minor drug offenses like marijuana when you can go to Colorado and get marijuana out of vending machines? They don't want to let our people go. But we got to say, let our people go. Let me show you what they did. Amen. Corrections Corporation of America, CCA, was established in 1983. Amen. They sold the idea, amen, to Congress, amen, about building more efficient prisons that lead less people to staff them. Amen. A savings to the American taxpayers. But they also increased, amen, stiffened the drug laws in all and across our nation. In the 1990s, which increased the prison population. And from 1990 to 2009, the inmate population grew to 1,600%. It grew 1,600%. And who do you think they were locking up? Justice is just us. Somebody say amen. They were locking us up at an alarming rate compared to other people. You see, I'm going to talk to my young people a minute. Can I talk about this thing? Can I tell them something? Amen. Another European boy will get caught with some dope, amen, in the car, and they will pull him out, slap his hand, call his mama, and tell her to come pick him up. You get caught with that same stuff, they gonna put cuffs on you, put you in the back of the car, take you down there, get your fingerprints, lock you up, and put you right in the court system. Because if they can, watch this now. Because now you are, now you are a criminal for doing the same thing that somebody else got a hand slap for. We must understand that they are trying to lock us up. But I'm sitting here crying today with the spirit of Moses. Amen. You ought to legalize whatever you need to legalize. Stop locking us up and let our people go. Pharaoh has our children. You know, lack of education leads to incarceration. Education. Amen. Don't. Education, not incarceration. Parents all across the globe whose sons and daughters are sold into human and sex trafficking are crying, let my people go. Can I talk about this thing a minute? You got billionaires. Uh-oh, help me somebody. Billionaires. Not millionaires. Billionaires. I'm going to leave that alone. Say amen. Out there chasing down our sons and our daughters for sex. Amen. Billionaires. Can I talk about it? I'm going to leave that alone. Amen. Crying, and the parents are crying, let my people go. Family members who watch their flesh and blood suffer from drug and opioid addiction, we need to say, let our people go. Opioids. Now, let me tell you something. We don't have no boats. We don't have no ship. Now, I saw the movie American Gangster, but I think he was the only one that was able to do that. Amen. Amen. Black man, they had to bring the drugs over. But other than that, everybody else out there slinging, they ain't bringing that stuff here. Somebody say amen. That's being put in our neighborhoods. Can I talk about it? But it ain't even illegal drugs no more. You know what? Opioids. Opioid addiction is real. Prescription drugs, legal prescription painkillers, Oxycontin, hydrocortin, Vicodin, morphine, codeine. I'm going to give you the slang names because y'all may not know the real medical names. OCs and Oxys and Perks and Vicks. Y'all know what I'm talking about now, right? Okay, y'all didn't know the medical name, so I just gave you the slang name. Amen. Amen. Heroin is still illegal. Now, I'll give you the slang name for that too. It's called junk. It's called smack. It's called black tar. It's called horse. Help me, somebody. Say amen. Let our people go. It's too many of us that's hung up on that stuff. Say amen. You need to bring some programs to our neighborhood to help get people off of drugs. Amen. We've been on drugs too long. Amen. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm going to get somebody off of crack. Let my children go. Let my children go. Let my children go. Their minds are confused with them tablets and them iPads and them iPods. And let me tell you something. It's been proven even in the 2016 election, amen, that they targeted Black America with misinformation. They're still doing it to our children. Amen. In times of slavery, I'm going to say this. In times of slavery, a slave could not have a book. To be caught with one, you're going to be whooped, and it might even cost you your life. Nowadays, we got books everywhere and can't get our children to read a book to save our lives. Somebody help me, somebody. Say amen. So many enslave themselves to a life of ignorance when they got books that they can pick up and read. Turn and say amen. Amen. Next time they say, buy me an iPad, amen, buy them a fake one and get them a book. Amen. Can I talk about it? Say, plug into this book. You'll be all right. You'll be just fine. Amen. I'm serious, y'all. Turn to your neighbor and say, let our people go. Say amen. How many of you know people that done graduated high school can't read? Say amen. I don't know what they're doing in school, but they're pushing them through. They don't know nothing about no three R's. You don't know what that is, Chef? Reading, writing, and arithmetic. Say amen. They don't know nothing about that. Let my people go. Let my people go. Let them come out of Egypt. Amen. Don't let them be ignorant. Educate them, because when you educate them, you elevate them. And so Dr. King said, we must come to see that the end we seek in society is a society at peace with itself, a society that can live with its own conscience. Our society, I don't know how in the world it's living with its own conscience. If you're watching the news at all, folk lie more. You don't know what the truth is. Everybody lying. From the president, everybody lying. Turn your neighbors, everybody lying. And they don't care. They get this, Sir Huckabee, she come out and lie. Everybody lying. Say amen. They get caught in the lie and still tell another lie. Say amen. Didn't they learn from mama and grandmama that if you tell one lie, you gotta tell another one? Say amen. Every time they open their mouth, I'm like, that's a lie, that's a lie, that's a lie, that's a lie. And they think you're stupid. Somebody say amen. That you don't know they're lying, and you don't need spiritual discernment to know they're lying. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, they need to stop lying. Let my people go. Amen. Amen. The moral conscience, the moral conscience now, the moral conscience. Rich folk are getting away with everything, and they are still locking us up. Say amen. How the rich man going to rape three? I'm sorry. I got to say this. How rich man, a billionaire, going to rape over 40 young girls and get away with less than house arrest? They took him to prison, but they let him go to his office 6 days a week. What kind of prison is that? Somebody say amen. Turn your neighbors and name them. There's a Moses in you. To become the community of faith that God has called us to be, the community that Dr. King envisioned, we need more Moseses who don't mind leading others to a better life. Heal the world. Make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. Let my people go so that they can go and worship me. Say amen. And once you get free, you ought to show somebody else how to get in that wilderness and worship God. Get into their wilderness. Turn to your neighbor and say, Moses, get into their wilderness. They need you in the wilderness. Say amen. The Lord is on the side of the oppressed. God delivered his people. The Lord is on the side of the oppressed. Are you on the same side as the Lord? Anybody here on the Lord's side? Anybody here on the Lord's side? Turn to your neighbor and say, I'm on the Lord's side. And there is a Moses in me. And if there's a Moses in you, you need to tell old Pharaoh, let my people go. Thus saith the Lord God of Israel, let my people go. One day, Jesus is coming back. Amen. He's coming back with the spirit of Moses to lead us out of this world, to take us to a land that was promised. He said, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go, I'll come again and to receive you, that where I am, you might be also. But you got to understand something. You got to go and tell everybody that they need to give their life to the Lord Jesus Christ. Do I have a Moses in here? Stand on your feet. Somebody that don't worry, don't mind telling somebody that you need to come out of your sin. You see, Moses, watch this now. What you must understand is that in the Bible, Pharaoh represented sin. Egypt represented sin. So you want to go down into these communities and tell somebody you need to come out of your sin and be saved by the power of grace divine. Get baptized for the remission of your sin. You know who they are. You look at them every day. You got to be bold enough like Moses to say, I'm going down into this crack house. I'm going down into this drug place. I'm going down into this club, and I'm going to tell somebody, one somebody, let my people go. Anybody realize that you were once down in bondage, that you were once in sin? Oh, but I thank God that while I was yet a sinner, Jesus died for me. He paid the cost that I might be free. Jesus looked at my life, and he told the devil, you got to let, hallelujah, you got to let my son go, because there's some work I got for him to do. He's got to go and serve me in the wilderness. It's hard in the wilderness. But if you go, God will go with you. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, there's a Moses in me. There's a Moses in me. Stretch forth your rod. Your rod and say, let my people go. Let my people go. Let my people go. Let me people. Let my people go. Let me tell you something. Any caregivers in here? You are Moses. Any people? Watch this now. Moses, amen. Takes it. Mothers, you automatically Moses is. Can I talk about it? You got to lead your children to holiness and righteousness and a closer walk with the Lord. Amen. You got to take somebody. Anybody in who don't mind, amen, getting a kid that ain't your kid and leading them to a better life. You are Moses. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, oh neighbor, stop acting like you don't know what he's talking about. There's a Moses in you. There's a Moses in you. There's a Moses in you. There's a Harriet Tubman in you. There's a Frederick Douglass in you. Help me somebody. Can I talk about it? Your mama was a Moses. That's why you here today. Your daddy was a Moses. That's taught you how to pray. Can I talk about this thing a minute? Hallelujah. Turn your neighbor to neighbor. Go down, Moses. Way down on Hill Street. Way down downtown. Way down in the red light district. Way down in Fox Hollow. Go down, Moses. Go down, Moses. Go to the gang meeting and say, let my people go. Go to the crack house. Let my people go. Go to the hospital and pray for them. Say, let my people go. Satan had me bound, but Jesus set me free. Let my people. There's a Moses in you. There's a Moses in you. And if you would. Oh, thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Watch this. God told Abraham, go to a place that I'm going to send you. Watch this. Watch this. Watch this. He told Moses, go tell Pharaoh. Get out on a hillside one day. When Jesus was getting, watch this. Jesus said, I'll go down and I'll save them from their sin. Then when Jesus was leaving, he brought all of them, his disciples, out on the hillside. And he said that word, that first word, that means stop doing what you're doing and do what I'm getting ready to tell you. Jesus had them all on the hillside. They were waiting for him to ascend. But Jesus said, go ye therefore, teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost. Go tell Pharaoh, let my people go. Go and save somebody from their sin. And you know what? You know what? He finished with these words and I'm done. He said, and lo, I'm with you. I'm with you. I'm with you. You ain't going by yourself. I'm with you. All I need you to do is go. Open your mouth. I'll speak for you. Step forth the rod. I'll pour the water. Can I talk about this thing a minute? Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, there's a Moses in you. And if you can't be a Moses, be a Harriet Tubman.
There's a Moses in you. There's a Moses in you. You got to be free. You can't lead anybody else to freedom unless you are free. So let the Moses come into you and say, I am free. Praise the Lord, I'm free. No longer bound. No more chains holding me. My soul is resting. is just a blessing. Yeah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm free. Are you free today? Are you different? I am free. Praise the Lord. I'm free. No longer bound. No more chains holding me. My soul's resting. Are you resting in Jesus? And it's just a blessing. Yeah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That's the only way you can lead anybody to Christ. That's the only way you can bring them out of Egypt. You carried Tubman and said, I'm free. I fear no man. If they catch me and put me back in bondage, I'm still free. I don't fear man, because the God I serve, he protects me. He keeps me. He fixes me and keeps. Hallelujah! I'm free. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's give God some praise. Let's come to the altar. Let's thank God for look where he brought us from. He placed joy in our hearts where there was sorrow. He placed strength where we was weak. And we are standing here today on the shoulder of our ancestors. We are standing in our tenderness where he with toughness of our ancestors. We are standing on their strength. When we grow weak, we are standing on the strength of our ancestors. We have hope today because they were in despair, but they knew a God. Praise God, praise God. Maybe you think you have everything you need. Maybe you think you have as much as you need. But we can never get enough Jesus. We can never get enough of his joy. We can never get enough of his love. And we need to come and thank God when we look back over our lives, not just from where our ancestors came from, but you look from your childhood, where God has brought you from until this present day. We have so much to be thankful for.